Getting ready to make silicone molds and resin castings, I needed a pressure pot. Now, this is a paint pot. You can get one at Harbor Freight. I got this one at Grizzly. It's a 2 1/4 gallon container. This one looks like it's made better. This has all been pressed as one piece, and it's got a rolled edge. This seals on the gasket. You can buy this by itself at Grizzly, cheaper than you can buy it at Harbor Freight. It does not come with a spray gun or a bunch of stuff you don't need. Now, it did have some fittings on here. There's like a T-block here and one here. It came with a pressure regulator. I threw the regulator and these pieces that screwed in here away. This piece screws into the bottom of this. I like to never got these, some of these fittings out of here. They tend to glue these in with what appears to be a mixture of pipe dope and Loctite. These are not very good threads. They don't appear to be tapered. When they screw in here, they bottom out and then they tighten the hell out of them. They are pretty tight, but I did get them out. This is a 1/4 inch pipe fitting on this side and 3/8 on this side. In putting these brass fittings in here, I tried Teflon tape, I tried Teflon pipe dope, and nothing would tighten up because the threads in these collars that are welded into this head appear to be a bit oversized. So finally I gave up on that, I cleaned it all up, I mixed up some JB weld, and I screwed these in here with the JB weld, and I got a good pressure test. A valve on here, you connect your air hose, look at the gauge so you can control how much pressure you put in the pot. And this tank is 45 psi maximum pressure, so it says on the tank. In the book it says 50. You can't get to 45 because this thing is a little cheap pop-off valve. It's trying to pop off at about 42 and it keeps leaking until it gets down to about 30. So I've got a new one on order on this. My pop-off valve is going to be 55 psi. You just have to be careful what you're doing. And anything, if it's designed to any type of code, minimum, if you have a working pressure, the test pressure should be 1.5 times that. Now, this being made in China, who knows? But that's what I'm doing. You do what you think you need to do. And on the inside, I put a tray. The bottom of that tank is concave. I put that tray in there so when I set a container of silicone or a container of resin, it's not trying to topple over. Put this lid on here and position it such that when you put these clamps on here, it's out of the way of this handle. When this is tightened down, connect your air hose and slowly pressurize this to whatever pressure you want. I suspect I'm going to be going up to about 40 pounds. I think that will be enough. And then, as soon as you've completed pressurizing, close this valve, take that hose off so you don't accidentally somehow overpressurize this container. And then make a small sign that will hang on here that says pressurized in big letters. You're going to pressurize this and walk away from it for a while and come back later when the resin or silicone or whatever has set up. And you don't want to forget that this is under pressure and absentmindedly start trying to loosen these clamps until you bleed the pressure off. One other thing that I've done in here, I screwed in a pipe plug and I cross drilled it in both directions so that when the air comes in here, that air is going in different directions and not blowing down directly into my container of resin or blowing stuff all over the place. I have the vacuum chamber and the pressure pot. Which one, or if you use both, is going to be determined by what chemical you use. Some chemicals, when you mix them, they generate bubbles or gas, and there'll be some air entrainment as you mix the two parts. You also have to consider what your curing time is going to be for what you're using. But generally speaking, if you have something that's going to generate bubbles or you want to get rid of air entrainment, you put the container in the vacuum chamber, you pull a vacuum on it for a little while until you see the bubbles stop coming to the surface. Release the vacuum, pour the product into your mold, put it into the pressure pot, close it up, and pressurize it. And what you're doing here is you're trying to compress whatever small bubbles or voids you may have in your mold to make them disappear. So between the two-part process, you're hoping to get a good casting with no bubbles or voids.